Hi, hello everyone, welcome you all. Now we are going to discuss the generation of high alternating voltages. So here there are the three different topics we are going to discuss, that is cascade transformer, then resonant transformers, followed by we are going to discuss that generation of high frequency AC high voltages. So when the test voltage which is requires less than the 300 kV, generally we will use a single unit of the transformer, and also you should have a 5% less than the 5% of the impedance, and should be capable to give a short circuit current at least of 1 minute, and also it is depending upon the design. So in addition to that, in the transformer we will have primary, secondary. In addition to that, we have third winding, that is tertiary winding, which is required for the meter reading purpose. What is the voltage which you will get across the secondary side of the transformer? So for the higher voltages, a single unit construction, it is very difficult, and also it will lead to that the costly of the insulation purpose, and also the cooling is also one of the major problem. Apart from this, we might be facing the transportation, and the erection of the transformer is also become difficult. So these are the drawbacks, so that we will go for a different connection by series or cascading of the several identical transformers, where that the high voltage winding of all the units effectively will come in series. Now we are going to discuss that the first one, that is the cascade transformer. So here just you see that the how actually the circuit diagram of cascade transformer. So we have the input which is generally fed by a MG set, that is nothing but the motor generator set, or sometimes you might be having an induction regulator as well. So this is nothing but the input voltage V1, and having the primary winding of AA dash. Then we will have a secondary winding BB dash, and this is another winding which is required for the measurement of what is the voltage across the secondary side, which you can see. V1 is input, G is nothing but insulation support, B dash is nothing but high voltage winding, BD is nothing but meter reading for the measurement of across the secondary side. So similarly, we will have different sets. So what is the input which we are giving? It will give to that the secondary side of the output of the first transformer. What is the step up voltage will fed back to that the input to the second transformer. This is the first transformer, this is the second transformer. Similarly, there is a rise in the voltage, that voltage will give as input to the third of the transformer, and you can see to that there is an insulation support which is kept on the insulation depending upon the voltage V2. So that there is an the voltage which is maintained by the second transformer. You can see to that there is a voltage V2 which is input to the second transformer, and the rise in the voltage, that is nothing but a V1. Okay, this is the input voltage which you are giving. Then there is a rise in the voltage V1 plus V1, this is resulting in, this is a 2V2. So this is nothing but earlier the across the insulation support is G, that is nothing but V2 voltage which is maintained, and rise in the voltage is 2V2. And similarly, this is the input which is given to that the third transformer, and there is a rise in the voltage across second third transformer, it is 3V2. So generally we will have a 2 to 4, but very often a 3 stages which is adopted to facilitate the 3-phase operation, so that we may get it is around 3 times of the V2 value. Then look at this, how actually there is a working of this cascade transformer is. So which is input is motor generator set, and this is input voltage will be around 230 or 400 volts. So single phase to 3-phase supply is depending upon that, and the transformer rating will be around 100 kV. So resulting in there is secondary voltage, we may get 3.3, 6.6, or sometimes it may be varies of 11 kV. So this is how actually there is a simple cascaded transformer. Then another type we have the cascade transformer is by using an identical transformer we could able to get there is a rise in the voltage across the output of the transformer. So which you can see that there is an IS1, IS2 and also IS3. So this is what the different type of the transformer we will have. So what is the purpose of this? The transformers are, this is the IS1, IS2 and the IS3 value. So this is nothing but this act like an isolated transformer. Look at the diagram here. This is input by the motor generator set V1. And you can see to that the what is the input voltage which is given, which is similar, which is same as other transformers. So you can see that this is the input to the first transformer. Similarly, there is input to the next transformer. Similarly, there is input to the next transformers. So this supply could be able to supply the voltage. This is supplied to the all the transformers. So the power supply to the isolated transformers is also fed from the same input voltage. This is the only the difference from earlier transformer to the there is a modified one. So this scheme is very expensive because which is requires a more space and also the lot of the transformers. So only the advantage of this method is that there is a possibility of the natural cooling and also the transformers will be in lightweight and also compact because a small rating of the transformer which we can use it for the high voltage rating. So this is transportation and the assembly is also a very easier one which you can see here which is noted down. And also the construction is also identical for the isolating transformers and the high voltage cascaded units. So there is a possibility of that a star and the delta connection is possible from this method. Generally the testing transformers of up to rating at 10 MVA in the cascaded connection will give the high voltage output of a 2.25 megavolt. It is both possible for the indoor and the outdoor application. So here the only the limitation by this method is, so it required too much of the transformers and as it is not the reliable one, but the advantage is that identical transformer which can use it for the rising the voltage. Now we are going to discuss a resonant transformer, that is the second concept. The circuit diagram and with the equivalent circuit diagram which is shown here. The equivalent circuit diagram which is consisting of a leakage reactance of the winding and the resistance of the winding and also the magnetizing reactance and also it is comprising of shunt capacitance across the output terminal due to the pushing of the high voltage terminal as well as the test object which is shown here. So from this which we can see that it is possible to have a series resonance where omega if that L1 plus L2 is equal to 1 by omega C. With this condition the current in the test object is very high and is limited to only by the resistance of the circuit. So the waveform of the voltage across the test object will be of a pure sinusoidal and the magnitude of the voltage across the capacitance C of the test object will be of Vc is equal to, that is nothing but minus J V into Xc divided by R plus J XL minus Xc. So by doing simplification you will get V by omega CR. So here apart from this we have two different types, that is nothing but a series resonance and the parallel resonance AC system. The factor that is nothing but XC by R, that is equal to 1 by omega CR. Under this condition that this is nothing but we will consider as the quality factor of the circuit and it gives an magnitude of the voltage across the test object. That is nothing but we will consider as a quality factor. So therefore the input voltage required for the excitation and also the output KVA is also reduced by 1 by q. That is nothing but the quality factor. Considering that the quality factor of the power factor is 1. This principle, which is used in a testing of very high voltages and an occasion of requiring a large current output, such as cable testing, dielectric loss measurement, and also a partial discharge measurement, that is nothing but the PD. A transformer with 50 to 100 kVA voltage rating, a large current rating, which is connected together, consider as an additional choke if necessary. Then the test object at this condition will become omega in bracket Le plus L, that is equal to 1 by omega C. So where Le is nothing but the total leakage inductance of the transformer. Then this, now let's discuss that. So what is the difference between series resonance and the parallel resonance, the transformer? So here look at that. This is the series resonant of transformer. There is an inductance reactor of L, which is varied by air gap, and the operating gain, which is the ratio of 10:1, and the capacitance C, which is the comprises of the test object and also the voltage divider and also the capacitance of the embushing, etc. So from this generally we will get the quality factor, which is around 50. So this is nothing but the series resonant transformer. Then we have a parallel resonant transformer. So this is nothing but the auto transformer and the circuit which is connected in. This is the parallel way with respect to the excitation of the transformer. The advantage of the parallel resonant is that it is a more stable output across the second hand side, and also it is independent of the degree of the tuning and the Q factor. So from this we may get a single transformer of up to a 500 kV that will later on I tabulated here. Then let's discuss that what are the advantages of this principle. Okay, so here it gives an output of in the formation of two sinusoidal. Then the power requirement, which is of very less, 5 to 10% of the total kVA rating. So this is nothing but by using that additional test object which is required. So this is the advantages. Then no high power arcing and heavy current surges across if the test object fails, as a resonance ceases at the failure of the test object. So this is the one of the greatest advantages we have. Then cascading is also possible for the very high voltages. It is simple and compact. Then there is no repeated flashover occur in the case of partial failure of the test object and insulation recovery. So if not, there is a, because of the partial failure, if there is a persist of the repeated flashover, there is a possibility of the breakdown may take place. So these are the advantages of the resonant transformer. Then we have limitation, that this is the only the limitation is a requires of additional variable choke which could able to withstand that a full voltage and the full current. So this is the only the limitation we have. So generally the regulator rating is 10 to 100 kVA excitation of this, and from this a single unit, that's nothing but a single unit resonant test system are built of output voltage 500 kV, while in the cascaded unit for output up to a 3000 kV for 50 bar 60 hertz, which is available. So this is nothing but resonance transformer. And next concept is generation of high frequency, high AC voltages. So high frequency, high AC voltages, which are required for a rectifier, a DC power supplies that we discuss in the earlier videos, and also for the testing electrical apparatus of a switching surges, which is high frequency, high voltage, damped oscillation, which are required. High voltage, high frequency transformers. Hence, let's go to that. The advantage of these high frequency transformers are that is absence of iron core in the transformer, hence in saving cost and the size. And also next one is, it is the output is of formation in a pure sine wave, and we have there is a slow buildup of voltage over a few cycle, and hence no damage due to the switching surges. And also we have one more advantage, that there is uniform distribution of the voltage across the winding coils due to subdivision of coil stack into number of the units. So commonly used high frequency resonant transformer is the Tesla coil. So this is one, the figure which I kept here. So which is nothing but it is doubly tuned a resonant circuit, which I will show it in the next slide. The primary voltage rating is around 10 kV, and the output which will get of 500 to 1000 kV. The primary, this is the equivalent circuit and the output waveform. So which you can see that the primary, which is fed by DC or the AC supply through the capacitance C1. This is the capacitance C1. And there is a spar gap connected across the primary, which is triggered at the desired voltage V1. So which induces high self excitation in the secondary, that is nothing but the, with the help of the winding of the transformer L1, and there is a mutual inductance between the primary and the secondary is M, and considering that inductance of the secondary is L2. The primary and the secondary windings, which is considered as L1 and the L2, which are wound on the insulated former, with there is no core, that is nothing but we'll consider it is an air core between these two, and these are everything is immersed in the oil. The windings are tuned to the frequency of a 10 to 100 kilohertz by the means of capacitance C1 and the, this is a C2 and the C1, or C1 and the C2. The primary coil, which is wound on the insulated fiber tube of about 1 mm length, which in the form of cylindrical or helical windings, and consisting of very less number of the turns, or that is nothing but few turns. The secondary winding, which is kept away from the primary winding, this is nothing but it is spaced quite away from the primary winding on the concentric fiber or pyrex tube with few thousand turns. So compared to that, the primary, it having the more number of the turns. The whole assembly, which is kept in oil tank under the pressure, with separate bushing, which is taken out for the both the primary and the secondary. The primary winding, which is supplied through the high voltage capacitor, a rectifier unit, the rating of a 10 to 50 kV or more. The power rating of the transformer may be of a 10 kV or more. Generally, the output voltage, that is nothing but V2, which is a function of L1, L2, C1, C2 and the mutual inductance M. So usually the resistance, which is very small and contribute only for the damping of the oscillations. The analysis which is done by considering that in a simple manner, neglecting the winding resistance. Let's consider that how actually there is a formation of the output. That's nothing but there is a damped oscillation which is get across the test offset. At the capacitance C1, which is charge, to the voltage V1. When there is power gap which is triggered, which is decided by the V1, that is across the capacitor C1. Let's think that there is the current which is flowing through the object is, this is nothing but a small I1, which is flows through the circuit, that is nothing but the L1, the current. And resulting in the mutual inductance, there is a current which is flowing through the secondary side of this transformer or the device, which is nothing but a small I2. By considering that, this is nothing but I2. By considering that, through the inductance L2 and the capacitance C2. Then, what is the equivalent circuits we'll get? Then, we'll have, this is nothing but V1, the input voltage is equal to, you should remember that what is the circuit diagram, then only we could understand this. V1 is equal to 1 by C, that is the power gap across that capacitance C1, which is vary from integration of 0 to t, the current which is flowing across the capacitance is I1 into dt. And also, it is subject to the inductance of the primary L1. So, L1 into di1 divided by dt. Plus, there is an inductance, that is the mutual inductance across the primary, is equal to m into di2 divided by dt. Remember this? This is subject to the reference to the primary. And coming to that, the secondary circuit is, there is no output voltage. We are assuming that it is V2 is 0. So that is nothing but is equal to 0. The capacitance C2 is nothing but, which varies, 1 by C2, integration from 0 to T, I2 dt. And also there is inductance across secondary side is L2 di2. The current which is flowing is I2, di2 by dt. Plus there is a mutual inductance, which is referred to the primary side, M into di1 by dt. By applying this, the Laplace transferred equation, so this equation become 1 V1 by S. So simplified this, L1 of S plus 1 by C1 of S, this is subject to the current I1. Okay, this is the capital I1 which you consider, and M into S into I2. And also similarly apply this, the Laplace transformation to this equation become 0 into, what is the common term here? I2 is the common term. L2 into S plus 1 by C2 of S into I2. And also M1 of S into I1. So where I1 and I2 are the Laplace transferred values by considering of a small I1 and the I2. And also we know that the output voltage V2 across the condenser, this is nothing but the test object, which is can be written as, actually we are supposed to write here only. Okay, so V1 0 and the V2. So V2 is equal to 1 by C2 integration 0 to T I2 into dt. See, this is nothing but its transfer equation. So by that equation, applying the Laplace transformation, we will get V2 of S, that is equal to I2 by C2 of S. So here, from this, the solution of V2 will become, V2 is equal to M into V1 divided by sigma into L1, L2, C1. So that's nothing but 1 by a gamma 2 square minus gamma 1 square in bracket cos of gamma 1 t minus cos of gamma 2 t. So where sigma square will become 1 minus of M square by L1 plus L2. So this is nothing but where k is the coefficient of L1 and the L2. So this is nothing but we need to calculate what is the gamma 1 and the gamma 2. So this is nothing but 1, 1 comma 2 is nothing but 1 is for the plus, another one is for the minus. that is equal to omega 1 square plus omega 2 square by 2 plus or minus in root of in bracket omega 1 square plus omega 2 square by 2 whole square minus omega 1 square omega 2 square. Okay, so where the subject of the frequency omega is equal to 1 by root of L1 LC L1 C1 and omega 2 is equal to 1 by root of L2 C2. So from that we will get the peak amplitude of the secondary side voltage will become, so the maximum output will become V2 maximum is equal to V1E root of in root L2 by L1. So where E is nothing but 2 in root of in bracket 1 minus of sigma divided by root in bracket 1 plus A square minus 4 sigma A. So where A is nothing but L2 C2 by L1 C1, that is equal to W1 square by W2 square. So this is nothing but more simplified formulation of test of coil represented by considering that what is the energy stored which is across the primary will transfer to that the secondary. This is the capacitance C1 and the C2 via a magnetic coupling. So by considering that if W1 is the energy stored in the C1 and W2 is the energy stored in the C2, and the efficiency will become this. Okay, so we have to calculate, there is a W1 is equal to half into sigma into, there's nothing but the efficiency, and the C1 V1 square. So this is nothing but from which we can get V2 is equal to V1 in root of in root, this is the efficiency C1 by C2. So this is nothing but from this the coefficient of a coupling is a large, the oscillation frequency is less. For large value of the winding resistance and the K value, the waveform may be become a unidirectional impulse. This is known in the next concept which we are going to discuss for the switching surges.